Glorificamus seats of the Holy Family, with gifts of the center of the fellowship. Brethren, put ye on, therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, the bowels of mercy, benignity, humility, modesty, patience, bearing with one another. Even as the Lord has forgiven you, so do you also. But above all these things, have charity, which is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ be found in your heart, wherein also you are called in one body, and being thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you abundantly, in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in songs, hymns, and spiritual canticles, singing praise in your heart to God. All whatsoever you do, in word or in work, you are in the name of the Lord, Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. When Jesus was 12 years old, then going up into Jerusalem, according to the custom of the feast, and having fulfilled the days when they returned, the child Jesus remained in Jerusalem, and his parents knew it not. And thinking that he was in the company, they came a day's journey and sought him among their people and acquaintance. And not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem, seeking him. And it came to pass that after 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the doctors, hearing them and asking them questions. And all that heard him were astonished at his wisdom and his answers. And seeing him, they wondered. And his mother said to him, "Son, why hast thou done so to us? Before thy father and I have sought thee so much." And he said to them, "How is it that you sought me? Did ye not know that I must be about my father's business?" And then they could not the word that he spoke to them. And he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was subject to them. And his mother kept all his words in her heart. And Jesus advanced in wisdom and age and grace with God and man. Let's talk a little bit about today's gospel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. Dear Father, dear fathers, dear brethren, dear friends, it happens today that the last day of my trip, my first trip to Philippines, my first visit, and I am honored to be here with you as we celebrate your patron, today, the Holy Family. So I want to thank Pastor Toto Terrido for inviting us and given us this honor. I want also to thank the priest who assist me. It's a solemn high mass. Though they are priests, they act as a beacon for their own cause. Thanks to him, I am here. the Philippines, and Father from Guam, and Father Robert, who you know, who are at the Beacon, the third Beacon. I would like to say a few words about the Solemn Liturgy, the Solemn High Mass. Again, though we have three priests, there is only one celebrant, little bit of the Holy Trinity, three persons and one God. So we have three priests at the altar, but one celebrant. The celebrant is the altar of Christ, the sacrificator, and we offer the sacrifice to God, to whom all together we pray and pray. The deacon assists the celebrant, especially in the offering of the sacrifice. You heard me, you send the gospel, you send the gospel for us, the symbolic direction, if it's in the east, I don't know if it's the graphic, but symbolically the cross is sent to the east. The gospel will be sent over the north, because in Roman times, the barbarians were in the direction of the north, the road, and the gospel with the light that spread over the barbarians for the conversion. That's why the deacon was here for the direction. As the deacon of the Roman citizen as the offertory, he will offer to give the priest the horse representing you, and he will offer the fruit of chalice on your behalf. And he will also distribute the Holy Communion. I mean, though you will not be today, we have Father Control can do it. So the priest, the deacon on his right, and the third deacon will be on the left of the priest, and that's the access to the deacon. And then he will bring the water, he will pour the water in the chalice. And after he will see you carry the packet. The most beautiful thing maybe from you, from the nativity, holding in the beautiful bed, he will carry the packet. He will hide the packet. Like in the front, it's bigger, and there's the currency of the boat, the bread, and in the chalice, he just is hidden. So the pattern will be covered in the funeral veil from the offertory to the pattern upstairs. The pattern is like a little plate that holds the horse. Because in the old church, there was only one mass, the consecration, and the Eucharist will be brought to the churches, carried in the pattern, that is a symbol of the movement of the subject in the pattern. So it's hard to pay attention to this movement. As you know, in liturgy, everything is important. Details are very important. Like in everyday life. Today we celebrate the Holy Family. You think in the daily life of the Holy Family, details were not important? It's very important. The way you dress, the way you look at someone, your hair, your clothes, your attitude, the tone of voice, everything has a meaning. And it's the same in the liturgy, which is the word of God. Of course, then. So, I would like to say a few words about my visit here. To tell you something, I feel really at home in Philippines because you have a great devotion to all your growth. It's everywhere. Everywhere. And in Tanglaman, Bobo, the statue of Origin of Lord is at the top of the high altar in the cathedral, and it's written in French. That's home country. Gertrude Immaculate Conception, I am Immaculate Conception. It's what Father Peter does here today. And also I feel at home with your great devotion to Santo Domingo. I want to say who? Our US province, where I've been working now for 7 years in America. Our US province is consecrated to the Eastern King. The Eastern King. And we have a looking up each month from the 17th to the 25th of each month with the body marks of the diocese. And our tribe is in Chicago, Illinois, the tribe of Christ the King. So I love your Santo Domingo with its roots of conquistador, except the red coat and really smart. Beautiful devotion we have in common. I saw beautiful things in the Philippines. All these young people who are in the mind of the Holy Father, Benedict XVI, to rediscover the old tradition, the treasure of the church. It is the name of the Holy Father, accepting that what was secret before remains secret for us. Otherwise, we will call in protection our own identity. This is the miracle of what I can call the miracle of Benedict XVI. Is that the liturgy is not to be created, to be invented, and not to be under experiment. The experience has been done for centuries and centuries by the church. So we have to rediscover, to deep, to deepen our knowledge of our own tradition. I hope you are in this in mind and you want to study, to appreciate and to pray the liturgy. After all, what we are looking for is God, God Himself. The liturgy is the official way of worshipping the Holy Trinity now. What we learn from Peter's Gospel is the love of the Holy Family for the temple, for the liturgy. The Holy Family would go to Jerusalem every year, a pilgrimage, to the temple where God meets man, the temple of Jerusalem, built by Solomon. Oh, this one is a big big actually. And when he was about 12, he said, it's time for to stay. And the pilgrims were on their way back to Nazareth, to Galilee. Jesus stayed. He was in the temple. And he didn't tell his parents. Because he loved the temple. He was thirsty for the temple. For the teaching and for the church. And when Joseph and Mary were looking for him, they went back. And they found him where? In the temple. We learn from Mary and Joseph how to see Jesus. Where do we find Jesus? In the tabernacle? In the liturgy of the temple? We have the grace, I think, of this mystery of the Lord of the fifth joyful mystery, the love of the finding of Jesus, is the grace to see God. Sometimes we are blindness, yeah. No, even the saints knew what we call the dark night of the soul, or the Teresa, and the brother talk about the dark night of the soul. We don't know where that is. But try to go to the temple, to go to the tabernacle, Jesus is there, that's your faith, the mystery of faith. So after the Holy Family, let us developing a special desire for the Lord in the future. I will ask you to pray for us, for my community, the Institute of Faculty. It's an institute of pontifical right, dedicated to the spirituality of St. Francis de Sales and St. Benedict and St. Thomas Aquinas, totally consecrated to the Immaculate Conception. That's why we have the blue compass of the very time. But also, we enjoy the privilege of saying the Latin Mass, the exponent from exclusivity. It's a privilege that has been granted to us. So, I've come here maybe to fancy, who knows, it's in God's hands. But pray for our Institute, as I will continue to pray for you, that my students may grow in wisdom, in age, in sanctity. When I was meeting Davao, I was meeting with the bishop and the Latin Mass Society. I asked the bishop of Davao, I said, "Bishop, is there any targets for selfhood, for beatification in your diocese?" And he turned to one of the young people of the Latin Mass Society. He said, "Yes, Father, they are here. They are here. It's good young men." So I hope we can say the same of you. You are the one who will be saints. Maybe they are defined if you can have. That's why the liturgy is our great means of sanctification. To not lead us to pride, but to humility, to purification, knowing that God is working in us through the liturgy to make us holy. As soon as we are able to offer ourselves to God, not to sin, not to purity, but to offer ourselves to God, God will transform us and will transform the bread in his body and the wine in his blood to make us life-giving. And we will enjoy the great joy of heaven with our little Lord and our Lady, all the saints of our world. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Spiritus Sanctus, Oh, Maria.
Thank you.
cum Spiritu Tuo. Ον Дух пишет эпдепичит анима мея, и на трия Домини. Орнеюм эт паропнея, exulta verunt in Deum Vivum. Tot ecum noster aspice Deus, et respice in faciem Christi tui. Non vivabit bonis eos qui ambulant in innocentia, Domine virtutum beatus homo qui sperat in te. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper,
et veni.
Oh.